There's no doubt that the heart of every home is in the kitchen. It's where you make great food and it's where friends gather. The challenge when you're renovating a kitchen is to have a great relationship with your kitchen designer. I've got Tina Scott from Cabinet Commander with us here today to share with her and you what a great relationship really means in the kitchen. Tina, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Wally. Glad to be here.
Well, give me the backstory. How does one become a kitchen design expert?
Well, it comes with a lot of customers and a lot of education and a lot of years of experience and a lot of training. But most of all, it comes with really enjoying what you do and working with different types of people all the time.
It's getting that right personality type, figuring out how is that person going to enjoy their kitchen so you can match that with the budget and then really execute.
Absolutely. And you have to make it personal. It's a very personal decision that they're making. So you have to have that level of experience to support what you're doing. But you also have to have the ability to make them feel good, because remodeling is one of the biggest stressors that anybody will go through.
Absolutely. You know, some people use the kitchen as a place to create art to eat, and others it's more of a gathering place. How do you approach those two different kitchen uses when you're working with a client?
Well, most of all, in today's trends, I tend to blow out walls and open up spaces so that the point of contact is not secluded into the kitchen anymore. I'm trying to bring forth that family and dinners and entertaining, whether it's takeout or cooking, can be done with everybody in the same vicinity. I gather that with large islands, bar tops, just different types of ways to make it feel that the flow is really comfortable for a lot of people, not just the cook.
When people are trying to decide, would I like an eat-in kitchen, if they have to choose, an eat-in kitchen or a separate dining room, how do you help them make that decision?
I ask a series of questions into what they use their current dining room for. I look at the size of the kitchen to find out if it's even possible. But outside of that, it's really getting to feel, do you have children? Do you have pets? Do you entertain? Do you only entertain on the holidays? And it helps them put in perspective of where their priorities are.
I see over the years, 25 years looking at houses as a home inspector, trends in countertops. There's things that tend to be trendy and look awful in 10 years, and there's things that tend to be timeless. What do you see as the most trendy thing right now? And what's something timeless I can put in my kitchen so I'm good forever?
Well, I can tell you that as a designer, I tend to stay away from trends because, as you know, it does date our project. Right now, the trend you're seeing is everything is pure gray and white, and we're tending as designers to step away from gray and white. We're introducing other colors and finishes that homeowners haven't seen for about 20 years plus, and we're bringing them in with classic details that are streamlined. So no curly cues or arched doors or anything that's going to remind us of Grandma and Grandpa's kitchen.
I had some good times in Grandma and Grandpa's kitchen.
We did.
All righty. For folks who'd like to spend some time with you, get to know you, and feel the process that you use, what's the best way to get a hold of you?
The best way to reach us is at our website, which is www.cabinetcommander.com.
I really enjoyed spending time with Tina and intend to spend a little more having her look at my own kitchen. Suggest you consider the same. Have a beautiful day.